Stay my time, TDM fans. Womp womp.
Well, it is official. KSI's ego has officially outgrew his forehead. For the longest time, I knew that he has a very, very big ego, but this whole drama that's been happening right now, it just proved it. After the whole Dan situation. To refresh your mind a little bit, 2 weeks ago, Dan just came forward after KSI, Logan Paul, Mr. Beast, they launched a new product called Lunchly, and they, you know, promoted it as it's a healthier alternative than, you know, Lunchables, and they absolutely shit on Lunchables. And Dan TDM decided to come forward and say, hey, what happened to YouTubers? They don't care about their audience anymore, and all they care about is making money and just, you know, false advertising, whatever they're selling. Basically, they all care about money. And KSI and Logan Paul, they acted like, you know, Dan insulted their ancestor. It's like Dan slapped their dog or cat. This was his first insult. This is his second insult. And then with the market situation, literally, we talked about, he said, what happened to you YouTubers, man? Basically, just using bad jokes to tease Dan and just laugh about the whole situation. Because if you're not aware of KSI, KSI can get away with anything, and all he does is add a laugh at the end, and everyone just laughs at his laugh and not at what he's been saying all along. This has been going on for a couple of years. He can go be like, what did the Irish man do when he walked into a bar? He started drinking. And I gotta give it to him, it works. People do actually laugh at his laugh, but he's been going on tweet after tweet squeezing this situation. Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the tweets are keep on coming and he keeps on talking about it. Because another thing I learned from KSI as well, he's a very big overthinker. Shocking with that size of forehead. There are a gazillion voices inside his head just talking. He's talking to himself. It is no more a YouTube civil war between Dan, KSI, Logan Paul, Jack DI. It is KSI versus KSI because he's fighting against himself because he's just talking to himself. He went on, he made a YouTube video, we covered it, you know, saying that people just hate us, everyone's doing it, but, you know, just because we're unlikable, we are getting all the hate. I tried counting how many times he laughed in that video, I literally lost count, and he's been going on, you know, tweet after tweet. He even tweeted one thing, and then he deleted it later on. But thanks to the internet, once you post something, it can never truly be deleted. He said, thanks for the free promo, pussy. Tagging Dan TDM, DM me your bank details for the payment, LMAO. Now, this situation could have easily been avoided. Just make that one comment, or maybe two, maybe three max. But he keeps on talking to himself, and that led to a lot of dislikes. A lot of people just disconnecting from KSI. Someone commented, I grew up watching you and now I've realized you never grew up. Do better. He absolutely got shitted on in the comment section, and the whole video had around like 80% dislikes and just 20% likes. Now, after seeing the results on that video, did KSI come to a conclusion that, you know, he's been overdoing this a lot, he's been overthinking it, he's been just, he has to take some things seriously because this is just one of the few times that he got himself into a criticism situation? Did he come to that conclusion and decide to apologize? Nope, the voices were not letting him go, because with that still there are voices in his head yapping and laughing at the same time. KSI versus KSI, I don't know what the fuck goes on in his head, but he decided to come out with this one video that embarrassed him even more.
A lot's happened these past few days, and I've had a lot of time to reflect and really understand everything that's happened and all of my actions. And, you know, first of all, I want to I want to apologize. I want to say sorry. Hey, yo, drink Prime and eat Lunchly, motherfucker. Stay mad, Dan TDM fans. Womp, womp.
Now, KSI, I'm going to uno reverse the quotation that you give Jack after he made that tweet, you know, towards you.
Except a guy, you mess with Dan TDM, you mess with YouTube. For me, that's cringe.
That's just cringe. Watching this whole video just made me literally cringe. Stay crying and making the hand gestures and then laughing and then motorboarding the screen. KSI, the only person who's crying is you at night and cursing at Dan. No one cares. I swear to God, if you stop talking about this, within a few days, we'll forget about the whole situation. Fuck it. Within a few hours, we're going to forget about the whole situation. The only person who is living in your head rent-free, haunting you until probably at this point, till the end of time, is going to be, you know, Dan haunting you. KSI, you're like 31, 32 years old. You're a millionaire. Why would you care about, you know, Dan, someone like Dan who made one tweet? Dan is just watching this and just laughing at how you're embarrassing yourself at this point. He doesn't even need to make a second tweet. Go live your life. Go make your video. Go have successful businesses, because no matter what we say, you know, he is still going to have a very successful business. Because no matter how many people hate them, there's still, you know, going to be people who love them and who would die to get their hands on a Prime just to show it off on social media, or have a bag of Lunchly just to show off at school that I have Lunchly. All of you are peasants. So no matter what, he's going to sell it either way. But what I think he's doing in this situation is trying to juice up the situation, milking it to an extreme to promote his Lunchly. And with this next one, he's I used to make fun of my grandpa for having a demon sneeze. Now as I'm growing older day by day, I know how they feel. Anyways, what he's trying to do is milk it as much as he can so he can get as much as exposure for his Lunchly pack, for his Prime, to sell more stuff and promote his music. As each of these tweets are getting at least 1 million impression, and the original tweets that he's been making, they have over 20 million impressions on each post. He kept on posting this website called myapology.co.uk. A lot has happened in the past few days online, so here I am addressing everything below. He got community noted saying not only this link is 100% misleading, which breaks ACE guidelines, it's also a marketing tactic for WMG, who created the site that's using anger surrounding his controversies to promote his new single. Let's click on the link and see where it takes us. I'm not going to accept any cookies. I don't know what kind of information they're going to take from me. But basically, you just click on it. It's like, click it again. And all you can see is the link to his new single that he just released. You keep clicking, he's trolling you and just wasting your time on this website. Click it again. I don't know why it's not working. Click it again and blah, blah, blah. He made this comment to the community guideline. The countdown is up. The apology video is now live, ready for you to view. So he's using sarcasm and satire to just have fun, fuck around with people, have fun with this whole situation, and promote his new music towards this. I think this is an absolutely the worst way to market his new single. It's like Diddy coming out and making an apology YouTube video and saying that, you know, yes, I did the things I did were horrible. I trafficked this. I 69 with that one. I drugged this one. I did all these things. And if you want to know every single detail about what time, where, how I did these things, click the link below in the, you know, the YouTube description. And, you know, it will take you to the full story as I wrote it down. You click on the link, it takes you to his new merch, Diddy Baby Oil. No one gives a shit about your single. Literally, not even 1% are going to be clicking on the music to listen to you. Everyone is there, you know, since you said there's an apology. There is no marketing in this whole situation. It's like trying to bring someone who watches short content, like 10 seconds, to YouTube when they have no patience to watch a whole 10-20 minute YouTube video. This is the absolute worst way to go with it. There is absolutely zero gain from the strategy that he's going towards with this. The only thing he's losing is his reputation and people's respect towards him. So I really can't tell you if this is in his insecurities talking or the mansion up here that he has. He has a lot of voices in his head. I don't know, but if he wouldn't have said anything, it would have been much better for him. But what's done is done right now. Going forward, let's see if he's going to make any more replies. But so far, like, everyone's absolutely shitting for KSI, and he just made everyone just lose a lot of respect for him. And before I end this video, I have a message for KSI. KSI, please quit your music thing. You're good at YouTube, you know, making YouTube videos. You're good at boxing. You're good at marketing things. Maybe not in this case, but, you know, promoting and Prime and all. Lunchly's marketing, you absolutely sucked at it. But just don't do music. There are some things. Music, singing is just either you have it or you don't have it. Just like dancing. It's like if I come forward and be like, guys, I know I make YouTube videos, I sit on Yap, but you know, my passion has been calling for different things. From today, I identify as a breakdancer, and you'll be seeing more breakdancing moves from me. It's just something you have or not. No matter how many times you use auto-tune, it is not going to make you sound better. I'm just saying. But anyways, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Take it easy. If you're new here, like and subscribe. I will catch you at the next one.